Fives are tough. Eights are rough. But if they get you to the money cards, that's enough on Kutchuk's. And here's the host of Kutchuk's, Jim Perry.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Kutchuk's. Nice to have you here with us. Thank you for joining us at home. Hello there, Gene Wood. And our thanks for the opening poem, Brian Trice of Porterville, California, watching us on KERO-TV, Channel 23. Yeah, you can get bad cards, but they get you to the money cards. That's what it's all about. And a lady who is at the money cards right now, our new champion, we're going to bring her out and wish her well. This is Debbie Newman. Hello, Debbie. Nice to see you again.
Thank you.
Before we get to the business at hand, won't you again remind us about yourself?
My name is Debbie Newman. I'm an ex-drill instructor from the Army. In the last 2 years, the last 15 months, I've traveled and lived in 7 different states. And right now I'm in California being a secretary.
Why have you lived in so many places in just 15 months?
It was my husband's idea. He's an attorney and he doesn't know what he wants to do.
Oh, okay.
So we just traveled.
Just traveling around there. Well, kind of got a little traveling attorneyship there.
Yeah.
Huh? Debbie, you cut the money cards?
Yes, I did.
Then let's open up the board and get to them right now. Come on up here. Open up the money cards. Ring over the podium. Step by step, it comes at us. And Debbie, hope you gave him a good cut because there's a lot of money up there. 7 cards can add up to $28,800 as Debbie steps up on the podium. And with those cards, $200 of new money on each level and a total of 7 cards. Remember, your minimum bet, $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must risk at least half the money. Good luck, Debbie.
Thank you.
Here's $200. And, of course, you can change your base card on each level. Thank you, Melinda. We'll start you off with $200 and a 10.
Change that card, please, Jim.
You can only change it once. You must play this one. A king
lower
card.
$150 lower, Jim.
$150 that this card is lower than a king. It is with a 2.
Oh, but higher.
For $700, higher than a 2. Yes, with a 5.
$350 higher.
$350 on a...
Higher.
Ooh, a big bet on a 5. Is she right? Higher. Yes, she is. $1,050 on the bottom level. A beautiful job. Up goes the 10. We'll give you the other $200.
Change
you have $1,250.
Please.
Made a good change before. Can she do it on this level? Yes, a 4. Better card.
$500 higher, please.
$500 higher than a 4. Right again. $1,750.
$50 lower.
Minimum bet, $50. Lower than a 9.
No.
Good you held back. $1,700. Still looking at a 9.
$50 lower.
$50 lower than a 9? Oh, what a great card comes up for $50. And Ace with $1,650.
All of it lower.
Double or nothing. Lower than an ace.
No.
No. Debbie, that is no way to start the day. Come on down here. My goodness. Ah. Well, you've still got $200. We'll meet a new challenger in a moment. Right now, let's take care of some business, and we'll be back. Hey, Debbie, Janice is dealing out 2 brand new decks of cards. Here comes our next challenger on Card Charge. Jesse Bowen. Hello, Jesse.
Good to meet you.
My pleasure, sir.
Looking forward to seeing you.
Good.
My name's Jesse Bowen. I live in Bakersfield, California. I'm married to a wonderful woman. I'm retired, and I have a hobby that's good for the body.
What's that?
Well, about 5 years ago after I retired, I bought me an old bicycle. One of them old timers. You have to pedal hard to get up a little hill or something. And I go around all over Bakersfield picking up old empty beer cans. My wife told me not to say that on television. She said, all of my friends will know what you do. I said, I don't care. I think it's nice, but I all worked all of my life. And I got to keep my body all built up so that I can go.
Well, what do you... That's nice. What do you do with the beer cans?
Oh, they bring me 25 cents a pound when I get about 200 pounds. Take them down, sell them.
Oh, I see. So you're making a few dollars.
Oh,
you're also cleaning up the neighborhood. That's terrific. Why would you? Your wife shouldn't be ashamed of that. That's a nice thing. That's a good thing.
Oh, well, these highfalutin people know. I said, I don't want you to know that you ride over by and pick up a nasty can.
How long have you been married to that highfalutin lady?
Oh, let's don't go into that. I'm on television.
Okay. Nice to have you here, Jesse. You got the cards?
Yes, I did.
Then here we go. Good luck to both of you. We start the best 2 out of 3 with a question to the champion. Debbie? Debbie, we asked 100 single women. Have men today forgotten how to be romantic? How many single women said, yes, men today have forgotten how to be romantic?
let's see, I'm going to think women are so into women's lib and men seem to resent it. And it's like they think, you know, women are like another one of the guys nowadays. So I would have to say...
No, they're not, Debbie.
Okay.
I remember. How many single women said men have forgotten how to be romantic?
I'm going
to
say 45.
45 out of 100. What do you think, Jesse?
I think men is as much today romantic as they was years ago. Of course, there may be a few drunks or slobs today, but the most of them, I'm going to say it's going to be higher than that, Jim.
You say, how many have forgotten how to be romantic? She said 45 have forgotten how? You think?
Oh, no, I'm going to say it's be lower than that.
That's what it sounded like where you're thinking was going. Yeah, Let's find out now.
Thank you for correcting me.
If you're, well, we don't know if I'm right yet, Jesse, but I just wanted to get your thinking straight. If it is lower, you'll play your cards. The actual number of single women who said men today have forgotten how to be romantic is 57. Oh, I don't think Jesse's thanking me. Debbie's got it. And okay. Debbie starts off the match with a 3.
Good. Higher, Jim.
Higher than the 3. Oh, no. Again, the cards fail. Debbie, a break for Jesse. He's got a 7.
I'll say lower.
You say lower against the odds. No.
Nope.
Stayed with the odds on that one. Janice will fill in the spaces. And Jesse, here's your first question. Jesse, we surveyed 100 prison inmates. These are all men who are currently serving time in San Quentin Prison. And we asked them, interesting question, are you in prison for a crime you committed while you were on parole? How many inmates are serving time for a crime they committed while on parole?
Well, I know you hear a lot of them, they get out and they get out and they go right back in, seem like a lot of them. So I'm going to say that's going to be fairly high, about 55.
55 out of 100 committed a crime while on parole, Debbie.
I would say, I don't know, it seems that you read all statistics and it keeps telling you that when you're in prison, they teach you more, you know, more crimes. So I'm going to say it's just a little bit higher.
A little higher than that?
Yeah, a little bit.
Interesting. I think you're both fairly high, though. On parole is the key to this one. Let's find out. The actual number of inmates who were in prison for a crime they committed while on parole is 27. It is not higher, it's lower. Jesse, you got it.
Change that card, please.
That's a lot. 27. Jesse can now change it, winning the question. An ace.
Good card. Good card. Lower.
Lower than the ace. Yes, a 2.
Good card. Higher.
Higher than a 2. Another ace.
Good card. Lower.
Lower than the ace. A 3.
Good card. Higher.
For the first game of the match. Yay.
Yeah.
Jesse gets 3 cards and goes all the way. Game 1 of the challenger in $100. Jesse's going to pedal around for a little while. We'll be right back with the next game after this. Game 1 of the challenger. Janice deals out same 2 decks of cards with the next cards off the top of the deck. Start game 2. A very profitable break there for Jesse. We just made a deal for him to stop over to Gene's house and pick up a ton of empty beer cans after the game. We start game 2 with a question to Debbie. Debbie, we found 100 women who have 10 or more children. And we asked them, have you ever taken a fertility pill? How many mothers with 10 or more children have taken a fertility pill?
Let's see. Since everybody's into this fertility pills, it seems, but I know quite a few people I've heard that had 10 kids, they weren't taking them. I'm going to have to say half, 50.
50 out of 100 have taken a fertility pill, Jesse.
Well, I know I have a sister that has 13 children, and she done like, but I believe it's going to be a little lower than that.
She obviously doesn't bicycle that
She's
much.
She's too old for that anyway.
You say lower than that.
Lower than that.
The actual number of mothers with 10 or more children who have taken a fertility pill is 2. That's all. Just 2. Yeah. They don't need any help. Jesse starts off this game with a king.
A good card. Lower.
Lower than a king. A 5.
Not bad, but I'm going to go higher. I'm going to take
risk
a chance.
Higher. The cards failed the challenger. There's a break for you, Debbie, and a free chance at a 7.
Let's see. Higher.
Higher than a 7. Yes, a jack.
Lower.
Lower than a jack. A 10.
Freeze, Jim.
And we move over the freeze bar. Debbie needs 2 cards to tie up the match. Question to you, Jesse. Jesse, in traditional China, young people ask their elders for advice. So we asked 100 senior citizen men in America, have your grandchildren ever asked your advice? How many senior citizen men said, yes, their grandchildren have asked their advice?
Well, now I'm a grandfather, and my grandchildren has asked me for advice time too, so I'm going to say that would be about, I'll say 45.
45 out of 100 say yes, they've been asked for advice, Debbie.
I always ask my grandmother. They always seem to have more patience than your mother does with you. I'm going to say that has to be a little higher.
A little higher. The actual number of senior citizen men who said their grandchildren have asked their advice is 56. It is higher, Debbie. That's nice to know that they seek them
change
out for
card,
help.
Please.
Debbie, you got a 10.
Change it,
and
please.
And she can change it. A 5.
Higher, Jim.
Higher than a 5. A 10.
Freeze.
One card separates Debbie from the tie. Question three to you, Debbie. Debbie, we found 100 men who are paying alimony to their ex-wife. And we asked them, is your ex-wife costing you more now than she did when you were married to her? How many men said it cost more in alimony than it did to live with their wife?
I've been married a couple times, and I know it's costing him more now. I'm going to say that.
Are you happy about that?
65. Very. I love him to be miserable. He made me miserable.
Right. He made you miserable? He should be miserable.
Right.
Debbie says 65 out of 100 say it's costing more in alimony than it did to live with him, Jesse.
Well, Jim, since inflation and everything's going up like it is, I believe it's going to be higher than that.
Even higher than that?
Even higher than that with all the inflation.
Costs more. You think maybe they should keep them then or something, huh? 65 for Debbie, higher for Jesse. The actual number of men who said it costs more in alimony than it did to live with their wife is 32. It is not higher. It's lower. Very much lower. And Debbie, you have a 10.
Change up car, please, Jim.
Big change for the champion. The 10 becomes a 6.
Higher.
If this is higher, she ties up the match. No. Couldn't do it. Jesse with a free chance and a king.
Good card. I'm going to go lower.
Lower than the king. Oh, no. Another king. And as Janice fills in the
that's
spaces,
the way the breaks go.
We are at sudden death. Someone has to win it on this play of the cards. Jesse.
Yes, sir.
We asked 100 psychiatrists. Generally speaking, do you think it's really possible for a disappointed lover to die of a broken heart? How many psychiatrists said, yes, it's possible to die of a broken heart?
Well, it might be possible, but if they live as much as a week after that, they sort of get over that. So I'm going to say that's going to be a low number, about 27.
27 out of 100, Debbie. What do you think?
To actually die of a broken heart, I'll go, I don't know, I'll say lower.
You say lower. I guess what we're talking about is, does it affect your physical well-being with feeling bad mentally? Let's find out. 27 for Jesse, lower for Debbie. The actual number of psychiatrists who said it is possible to die of a broken heart is 50. Not lower, it is higher. 50. Jesse, you have an interesting board here. You've got control and sudden death, but Debbie needs only one card while you need four. Do you want to play it or pass it?
I'm going to let Debbie have it.
You're going to get it right
I'm
down to this
it
one
right
card.
Come on.
Debbie, if you call this right, you tie up the match, but if you make one mistake, we have a new champion with a 6.
Higher!
Is it higher? No! Oh. Jesse is the new champion! Jesse got control and sudden death and won it. Debbie, you didn't have a lot of luck, but you're a good player, and I hope you had fun. With a couple $100 and some nice party gifts. Thank you, Debbie.
Thank you very much.
Debbie Newman.
I sure hate to see that card go again in them Aces a while ago.
Come on over here, Jesse. Yeah, I guess you're rooting for and rooting against somebody.
Yeah,
well, Jesse, I hope you're not going to get any doubles at all.
Well, thank you.
Let's get some big money for Jesse Bowen right after this commercial break. Here we go.
Want to play?
Or lower.
Guess right, and win big.
Oh, you thought these were normal size, didn't you?
Joel McHale hosts Card Sharks, premieres Wednesday, June 12th on ABC.